Hello everyone, this is Sumit Kumar and today I am going to do matrix theory. I mean, in matrix theory, I chose today topic is something related to rank, finding rank of a given matrix. And suppose if someone will not give you matrix, suppose A is 5 cross 5 matrix or 6 cross 6 matrix, they will not give you the matrix, but they will give you the Kerr polynomial. Look, this is the Kerr polynomial of this matrix, and with this information, find the rank of the matrix. So how one can find the rank of that matrix? So today I am going to do that. Well, how one can approach those kind of questions when matrix is not given and they are asking about the rank? And it's not so easy problem, because now last 2 years there are many questions has been asked in competitive exams like NET, GATE and BHM, JAM, and they repeatedly asking finding the rank of a matrix, but they have not given that exactly what is the matrix is. And Kerr polynomial they will give you, minimal polynomial they will give you, and with this information they are going to ask the rank, trace, determinant, everything. So today I am going to do that. Okay, fine. So this question, but with this question asked in this NHM exam, this 2017, and this is the question. So A is a 5 cross 5 real matrix, and the Kerr polynomial of this matrix exactly they have given this. Okay, x to the power 5 plus lambda x to the power 4 plus beta x to the power 3, where alpha and beta non-zero real numbers. This is very very important. Then they are asking what are the possible values of the rank of A. Okay, so how one can approach this question? You know, if they have not given you the matrix and asking about the rank, how one can solve? So you know, solving this problem is not important. Okay, to understand the concepts involved in this question, that's important. Question will come and goes, but concept is as it is. So let's try to learn concept involved, particularly in these questions. Okay, so here, so my goal is how one can think. So how to think this problem? So recall what is given. So A is some 5 cross 5 matrix in over real number. Okay, and they have given you the Kerr polynomial. Well, so Kerr polynomial of A of lambda. Now I will write lambda. I feel comfortable while writing lambda. So this is nothing but lambda to the power 5 plus alpha lambda to the power 4 plus beta lambda to the power 3. Okay, so this is your Kerr polynomial of this matrix capital A, where what is the condition over alpha and beta? The condition over alpha and beta, they are non-zero real numbers. Alpha is not equal to 0, beta is not equal to 0. Then what you can say about the rank? That's the question. So let's try to find the answer from the given information. So here Kerr polynomial is this. Take lambda to the power q outside, common. So you have lambda square plus alpha times lambda plus beta. Okay, now my goal is to give the rank of this matrix with this information. Fine. Okay, you know, there is to give the answer of this question, I mean, from now it's very easy. It will take just 1 second or 2 seconds, but I'm not wanting to give you the answer. I want to say, look, these are the concepts involved in this question. So alpha and beta are non-zero real number. You know, this is a quadratic expression. Look at this very carefully. This is a quadratic expression. So this particular term, this factor here, beta and alpha is non-zero. So all roots of this equation, particularly if you solve this equal to 0, is going to be non-zero. Okay, and because product of roots is equal to beta, so beta is not equal to 0. Hence, these two roots, whatever roots you will get from here, let's say A and B, this all is going to be non-zero. So this route, you will get at least two routes, A and B. Maybe both are same, doesn't matter, but non-zero. Okay, so from here I can say rank of this matrix is at least two, because you have two non-zero eigenvalues. If you have two non-zero eigenvalue, the rank is at least two. So for a given matrix A of size n cross n, if you have, let's say, a matrix with say you are saying that there are k non-zero eigenvalues, then rank of that matrix is at least k. Well, how one can answer that question? K are non-zero eigenvalues. How you can say so confident way that rank of that matrix is at least k? So there is a theory that's called Jordan canonical form. If you heard about it, what Jordan canonical form was proved was tremendous in matrix theory. In topology also, Jordan has done very good amount of work. That's called Jordan curve something. But in matrix theory, Jordan canonical form is saying, if suppose this is your Carré polynomial, and look at the roots of this polynomial, that's called eigenvalues. And if that root belongs to your field, here field is my R. So actually that the construction where they are considering the algebraically closed field. So here, if suppose all roots of this Carré polynomial is going to be in over R, and now you can put it, that matrix, into Jordan form. So there is certain kind of form, there is certain way of represent a given matrix while choosing a suitable basis, and that representation is called Jordan canonical form of a given matrix. Okay, and it's always unique. If you give me that matrix, there is a unique representation of that matrix. So that construction was given by Jordan, so that's called Jordan canonical form. And what in Jordan canonical form is exactly, in the diagonals you can write the eigenvalues of that matrix. Okay, so this is somehow like upper triangular matrix, where in diagonal all eigenvalues should be there. So you are getting at least two non-zero eigenvalues. That means there will be two non-zero values along diagonals of a upper triangular matrix. Hence rank is at least two. So that's the answer to this question. So rank is at least two. So for that, you should know Jordan canonical form. I know some of them are not very comfortable with Jordan canonical form, but I'm promising you, it's not so tough. Try to learn Jordan canonical form. It's so easy and so elementary, because in the future you have to use it again, again and again. So it is better to be confident with Jordan canonical form. Try to learn Jordan canonical form. Okay, so here is this. So if I say, what are the roots of this polynomial? So you know, if you solve it, you will get lambda equal to 0, 0, 0, 3 zeros. And here you will get maybe real, complex, we don't know. So just I'm writing A and B. Okay, without loss of generality. Sometimes alpha and beta are real, but even though you will get complex root, it's possible. For example, if you look for lambda square plus lambda plus 1, right? If alpha and beta is 1, then if you take alpha is 1 and beta is 1, you will get this, and roots of this are cube root of unities. So omega and omega square. So that's not real. That's why I'm writing A and B. Over A and B, there is no condition, but they are non-zero. They may be same, they may be distinct, they may be complex number, I don't know. No information, that totally depends on alpha and beta. For complex, I have given you this example, okay? But these are non-zero. So, with this information, what you can say about the minimal polynomial? To write the Jordan canonical form, you should know the minimal polynomial. That is whole thing about the Jordan canonical form. So, minimal polynomial concept is, minimal polynomial always define any annihilating polynomial. Also, roots of minimal polynomial and Carré polynomial is going to be same, but different multiplicity or same multiplicity, that we don't know right now. So with this information, your minimal polynomial is going to be lambda to the power some k, and because this root, I don't know if all are distinct. If all are distinct, fine. If all are same, no information. So for with this information, I can say this, if roots are distinct, then this. If roots are not distinct, then maybe if same roots are going to occur, then we have no idea. We have no idea about, so okay, if you if roots are distinct, if A and B are distinct, you know, then it, this factor should be there. If suppose even the roots are same, suppose A and beta are same, doesn't matter, then maybe chances this is going to appear, but at least one factor should be there. Okay, so at least one factor should be present in minimal polynomial of your this. So if you are going to write the Jordan chemical form of this, then what is the condition over K? K will be at least one and maximum three. And oh, you know, for this is this should be there, or its factor or its divisor should be there, that loosely totally depend on alpha and beta. You know, if suppose I say, suppose if you give me, for example, what I am saying is, take example, better to take example, if alpha equal to 2 and beta equal to 1, then your Kerr polynomial is this, lambda cube, lambda square, 2 alpha plus 1, right? So this is lambda cube, lambda plus 1, the whole square. In this case, minimal polynomial of this thing can be this. Minimal polynomial for this Kerr polynomial may be this. If you have not given me the matrix, exactly what is the matrix of 5 cross 5, then there exists a matrix of 5 cross 5 with Kerr polynomial this and minimal polynomial this. Why? If that matrix is diagnosable, then positive. Exactly this is the form. Okay? That's what I'm saying. This thing, I have worried. I am worried here. This factor may be there or divisor of it. We don't know. So divisor of this factor is lambda plus 1. And if you take this distinct roots, and in the second example, if you take this, alpha equal to, if you take alpha equal to 1 and beta equal to 1, then all roots are distinct. You got cube root of infinity. Then this factor should be there. So this factor totally dependent on alpha and beta. If roots are identical, maybe single divisor of that, and if distinct, then whole factor should be there. Okay? But that doesn't matter. And k, what is the condition? K will be at least 1 and maximum 3. That's what you see. I have taken k exactly 1. When this, if 5 cross 5 with this Kerr polynomial, and that polynomial is diagnosable, means the minimal polynomial comes in linear factors. So that's why I have taken this. Otherwise, we should take this. Okay? So be confident. If your theory is so sound, if your knowledge is so sound, your hand will be very smooth. You will not be worried, okay, this thing will come or not. You will be very confident, yeah, this is true. Maybe matrix will be diagnosable. Maybe. If matrix is not diagnosable, then lambda plus 1 ka power something will be there, lambda ka power something should be there. That's compulsory. That's the theorem exactly. Okay? So do like this. Okay. So now let me raise it. So Kerr polynomial, overall whatever we have discussed so far, Kerr polynomial for this matrix is given this, and using this minimal polynomial, because we had this one factor of lambda should be there, and here we are doubtful, whatever, doesn't matter. But anyway, if you want, so my claim, rank of that matrix is at least 2. I told you, for rank, so and can be rank, can rank of A be 5? Can the rank of this matrix 5? See, what are the roots of this? Roots of this, zeros are coming 3 times. Means spectrum, 0 is an eigenvalue. If 0 is an eigenvalue, matrix is never going to be like invertible or whatever you can say. So rank of that, so rank of N cross N matrix is N, if and only if matrix is invertible. But here, determinant of that matrix 0, because 0 is an eigenvalue, hence rank of this matrix cannot be true. So this is false statement. So this is not going to be true. Rank of A never be 5. So it's not, because 0 is an eigenvalue. Okay? 0 is an eigenvalue. So rank of A is never going to be 5. Okay? So what are the possibilities? With so far discussion, rank you are saying at least 2. Rank you are saying at least 2. And it's less than 5, it's not going to 5. So what is the more appropriate? Less than equal to 4. Exactly. Okay, can it be 4? Of course, can it be 4? Yes, I can give. If Kerr polynomial is this, lambda square plus alpha lambda plus beta. Look at this. So, case one. When you are to construct, So in that case one, if minimal polynomial is exactly this. Exactly this. If minimal polynomial is going to be exactly this, then on that case, your Jordan chemical form A is similar to this matrix. 0 will appear, Jordan blocks, this is your 3 cross 3 matrix, 1, 0, 1, okay, and then 0, 0, 0. This is the Jordan block corresponding to lambda equal to 0, and then for here. Here you will get two non-zero angles. They may be same or distinct, I don't care. Rank is not going to affect. So if they are distinct, eigenvalues, so it will come in linear factors like this. So what is the condition over this? So A is not equal to 0 and B is not equal to 0. So A and B are zeros of this. Maybe real or complex, we don't know. So I'm writing over the complex field because rank is not dependent over the field and all those things. Okay. So here this. So in that case, if you take this column, this row, and this row, you will get your 4 cross 4 matrix, upper triangle matrix, and rank of this matrix is 4. So I got a matrix with rank of that matrix is 4. If minimal polynomial is this. Okay. So elementary, you know. That's why we have read Jordan chemical form. What is the application then Jordan chemical form? It's not about you give me matrix then I can write minimal polynomial care polynomial. It's about to understand the care polynomial. It's about to understand the matrix exactly. Okay, rank is this and this that. Okay. Case 2. If you want, rank of matrix should be 3. That means rank I need 3. These two are fixed. They may be distinct then. Anyway you are getting two non-zero eigenvalues, so rank either you can write distinct or you make it a block, doesn't matter, rank will be, if they are same, maybe you will get the 2 cross 2 block or singleton blocks, doesn't matter, rank of these two block is always 2. Trouble is here, sometimes you will get, because this is dependent on minimal polynomial, 3. If minimal polynomial of this is, if you take this, that's why I'm saying here the doubtful, but doesn't matter. This is not going to affect the rank. Rank is at least 2, but it is going to affect the rank. So in that case, Jordan block of this matrix is lambda square. So there will be 2 cross 2 Jordan blocks corresponding to lambda equal to 0. So one single 0 is there, right? So this, and then there will be Jordan blocks 0, 1, 0, 0. Okay? So here you are getting 0. 0, 0, and now you will get A0 and then 0, 0. Okay? So this is your Jordan blocks. So rank of, take this row, this row, this row, and this row, this column. So rank of this matrix is exactly 3. Okay? So beautiful application of Jordan chemical form. You know? And now case 3. So this is case 1, case 2. Case 3, if you need rank of matrix is exactly 2, then look at this. So, on that case, take the minimal polynomial of this. Lambda and then lambda square plus alpha lambda. I say, no, this is not going to affect the rank. This will always give the rank 2 at least. So, I said rank is at least 2. Doesn't, because you are getting 2 non-zero eigenvalues. Doesn't matter. And that case, A. So, here, each Jordan block is of size 1. So 0 corresponding to lambda equal to 0, this is 0, and you are getting A and B. So this overall matrix, you will say you are getting 3 cross 3 matrix, here 0, 0, and now A, B. Okay? So rank of this matrix is 2. So see, with given this information, I can compute the rank. Okay? I will not give the rank exactly, okay, this is going to be rank, but I will say lower bound and upper bound. The rank of this matrix is at least 2 and maximum 4. It cannot be 5 because rank of A is 5 means all eigenvalues are non-zero. But 0 is an eigenvalue with multiplicity 3. Okay? So rank of that matrix is at least 2 and up to you are getting this. Okay? So there are also, and there is also another way to answer this question related to vector space. That's called eigenspaces. That's also elementary result, but I thought that's very basic. You should learn that. But this is a beautiful application of Jordan Tankel form to find out the rank of a given matrix in terms of Kerr polynomial. So if you give me Kerr polynomial, I can give you the whole biodata data of a given matrix. Okay, so this is like thumb. If you give me the Kerr, I'll give you the exactly rank, what is the going to be rank of that matrix. Okay, so try to learn this concept very much. Okay, be confident with Jordan Tankel forms and stay connected to parts of eigenvalues and eigenvectors, and feel free to ask to your seniors, ask to your teachers related to those kind of stuff. And if you are not getting your answer, please mail me also. Once I'll get time, I'll try to solve the questions. Okay, so best of luck, and if you're interested in maths, hopefully come to me and I'm going to guide you. There is no problem at all, and stay blessed, work hard. So okay, and best of luck for GATE and IIT exams. So thank you. Okay, bye.